Hello and welcome to this full tutorial and guide on how to set up screen time and parental controls on your kid's iPhone or iPad or any iOS device for that matter. So there's a couple of ways that we can go about doing this. You can go to the settings on your child's device. So you can open up settings here, and then under settings, you're going to see the option that says screen time. It's got the hourglass. If we tap into that, that's going to be where we can set all of the parental controls up. Now, you can also do this from your device if they're under your iCloud account by going back to settings and then tapping into your family there, going to family, and then taking a look at their device by just tapping into their name. So for my youngest child, Millie, I can tap into her name there, and then I can tap into screen time here. Now, as you can see, her daily average is 42 minutes, but if screen time is not enabled, you just tap the button that says turn screen time on or enable screen time from this panel here, and that will enable screen time. So it doesn't matter if you get there from your device or on their device. You just go to settings and then screen time, and then once there, you need to turn that on, and that's where we can start working with all of the settings, and we can customize it per the age of your child. So here we are, once we've enabled screen time, we're going to see a couple of things here. I'm going to go from top to bottom. The first is going to be under the limit usage section. We have downtime, where we can schedule time away from the screen. So if we tap into downtime here, there will be a passcode, by the way. You need to make sure you remember your passcode for screen time. Mine is set up, and I did that earlier before the recording. Now, under downtime, you will see that we can turn on downtime until tomorrow. So you can actually tap that, and that will basically disable them from using their device or accessing anything on their device until tomorrow. Or you can schedule it. So we can tap into schedule here, and then we can go ahead and go to every day. And then we'll say from the time of, let's just say 10 a.m., right, until let's just say 5 p.m., we want them playing outside, not looking at their devices. We'll go ahead and tap into done. As you can see, that is scheduled downtime, and basically for all of her devices, downtime reminder will appear 5 minutes before and then after whenever you're ready. And then what you can do is basically if you want to block downtime, so basically the device will be blocked at downtime, Millie will be able to ask for more time from a parent or guardian. Just know that a lot of these things will ping you and notify you when they're trying to do things that you have them blocked from doing. So you can set your downtime here and you're good to go. I'm going to go ahead and uncheck that right there. And as you can see, you could do a couple of things there. Now tap the back option there or tap on screen time just to get back to the screen time option. Next, we're going to have app limits. This one's very important. If we tap into the orange hourglass there that says app limits, we can actually add limits to specific apps. So we can go to add limit. And then you can see that all of these apps here will be limited. So if we want to limit their entertainment, like YouTube Kids, things like that, we can actually select all entertainment, or we can even select into entertainment, and you can see what basically is included in that category. So if we uncheck all there, you can say, I only want them to use YouTube Kids for a certain amount of time, so I'm putting a limit on YouTube Kids. You select entertainment dropdown, select YouTube Kids, and then tap next in the upper portion of the screen. Now, what are we limiting them to? So we're going to say we're going to limit her to 2 hours every day to use YouTube Kids. Once that limit is reached, it will block that app. So the app will be blocked when the limit expires. That means that the child will be able to ask for more time, but unless they get that, it'll basically brick that app and they will not be able to use it. So when you're ready, you go ahead and go add. And as you can see, that will add a limit or a stop limit for that specific app, YouTube Kids, every day, 2 hours every single day. If you want to remove the limit, you go here to app limits, tap into it, and then go to delete limit one more time, and that will basically remove it. Now let's go back to screen time by tapping the breadcrumb there in the upper left-hand corner. Now, the next thing under limit usage is always allowed. Choose apps to allow at all times. So if we tap into this, this basically works the opposite. So if you only want like your child to be able to message or FaceTime or call, you can see that the allowed apps at all times are going to be the phone, message, FaceTime, and maps. Those are probably a pretty good selection of apps to have always available. But if you say, hey, I want them to always be having access to their camera, well, you tap in the camera there to add that and any other app that maybe they like, you know, and it really helps you as you're trying to do parent stuff, right? So you can select those apps and put those basically If you have any restrictions on the device, this will go around those. So you may have their device bricked and they can't do anything, no screen, you know, have no access to screen time, but they will have access to use messages, FaceTime. You get the point, right? You can add always allow apps right here. Also, allowed contacts. This one's a big deal. My daughter, who's 9, has a bunch of friends and contacts and people, and we're trying to manage it and make sure she's adding the right people, just family. But if we go into contacts here, you can actually allow them to communicate with everyone at all times or specific contacts, and then I can choose from either my contacts or add a new contact. So again, if you only want them to connect with specific people like family members, you can do that here in allowed communication by adding them directly to their device, like mom, dad, aunt, uncle, grandparents, things like that. Now let's go back to screen time once more. Next, this one really quickly, screen distance, reduce eye strain. Basically, to reduce eye strain, screen distance will alert you to hold an iPhone or iPad with Face ID at recommended distance. Honestly, I had this turned on for both of my kids, but I don't even think it's even triggered once. So I wouldn't worry about that unless you're really worried about your kid's eyesight. Next would be communication. Now, this is kind of what we were talking about earlier, communication limits. If I go to communication limits, this will actually allow me to disable or enable, say, hey, you can communicate with your friends during screen time, but during downtime, you can't communicate with anyone. So during screen time, when they're allowed to have screen time, you can see here that they can do everyone. But you can change that to contacts only, contact and groups with at least one contact, or everyone. So you can go in here and really fine tune who you want your kid to be able to speak to at what time. Same thing goes for during downtime. You can also go to manage Millie's contacts. So basically contact management, you can manage the contacts of your child after the request has been accepted, but you're obviously going to accept it on their device. And that will allow you to go into here on your device, see their contacts and add remove people you want or don't want in their contact list right here under communication limits. Now we're back under screen time. The next one's going to be restrictions. This one's very important and this one is probably the one you really want to pay attention to. So under restrictions, we can go into content and privacy restrictions. There's a whole list of things here. The first one that you want to do is make sure this is enabled. This will allow you to fine tune the apps they're able to see, whether they need to request to download anything. All of that stuff happens here. So this is kind of your main parental controls within your device. So the first one is iTunes and App Store purchases. You can see that I have installing apps. I've allowed that. Deleting apps. I've allowed that. In-app purchases, I would certainly not do that. And then require password, I have set to always require. So I always want the password, which they don't know, by the way, in my case. That way I have to get the device. It's a little bit frustrating, but you don't want them buying or purchasing in-apps purchases or apps that require actual money, right? Only the free apps are the ones that you've approved. So that's going to be under the iTunes and App Store purchases. Next is allowed apps. If you go into there, you can see that basically we have these apps allowed, but like for the most part, you might want to disable Wallet or AirDrop or CarPlay because they have no use for any of that. They don't have an email right now. You may not want them using the web and Safari. You can disable that there. So again, these are all apps that you can go and fine tune as to which ones you want allowed to be. And basically what that means is when they try to tap into the app, it'll remove it from their home screen. But when they find it on their app library, it will not open, right? Next is content restrictions. This is probably one of the most important things we'll talk about. Allowed store content. So music, podcast, news, and fitness, none of my kids do any of that, but if yours do, you can tap into that and say only allow clean, listed as clean audio files, right? Music videos, I have that turned off. If you want them to be able to see or view those, you can turn that on. Music profiles, had that turned off. Movies, I have set to G-rated. TV, only G-rated, and this is for the Apple Store, by the way, not like Disney and Netflix. Those are things you'll have to manage within those apps. Books, clean, you can go through here, and the one I like is apps. So if I go to apps here, you can choose for basically them to have apps to be able to download and open, but only for a certain age group. Now, again, this is kind of really up to the eye of the beholder because Roblox, which is one that my older child really likes, is 12 and up, but she's 9, so I had to up that. But I could add that to an allowed app if I wanted to. But you can go here and fine-tune this by choosing the age bracket that you want your kids to choose. App clips allow. Web content, if we go to web content here, you can see that allowed websites, but only allow these websites. So for my kids, it's like Google, Disney, How Stuff Works, PBS Kids, things like that. You can go in here, but if you wanted to, you could actually tap into that and slide to the left there and delete a website from the allowed websites, right? So you can go in and fine tune that as always. Web search content with Siri and explicit language, I'm not allowing any of that. If you want to, you can. So here under content restrictions, you can do all of that. Now, if we go back, the last thing that we'll look at here is share my location. Basically, if you go to share my location, it will allow. That way you can be notified and see and under like find my iPhone where the device is, hopefully with your child, and you can keep track of where they are and who they're with, that kind of thing. And then allow changes, passcode changes, account changes. Now, you can disallow all of these things. So I probably actually should disallow these things. So like passcode changes, I shouldn't allow that. Account changes, I probably should don't allow that. And then you can go through and allow what you want and what you don't want. So that's really it. And then the final thing would be I can change my screen time passcode. And this is something that you should know and they shouldn't. And then you can also turn off app and website activity. And then you can actually remove screen time if it's bugging you and it's annoying you. You can actually go to stop managing the child's screen time and that'll stop that from happening. And none of this will be applied, right? And they'll have full reign over their device. Now, if you have any questions, you can put those in the comment section below. If this helps you out, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next video.